We've done numerous stories about how climate change will make certain foods extinct. For instance, we did a story about how bacon might be extinct because of climate change. All right, everything will be fine, okay? You guys will be fine without the bacon. And then we did a story about
coffee,
and that's when I freaked out.
That's a bit rougher.
That's a little rougher. Yeah. All right, so the climate change stories, I like it because the climate scientists are now trying to find ways to appeal to the average American, that maybe typically wasn't interested in climate science to begin with. But I just recently read this article on the Daily Beast and Newsweek about how climate change can really severely impact something known as durum wheat. Now, of course, it will impact wheat, period, but durum wheat is a very specific type of wheat. It's high in protein, it's a very particularly nutritious, hardier wheat. And it has to be grown in very specific climates. Yeah. So it needs to be a cooler climate. It has to be relatively dry. You can't have much rainfall. So there are very specific areas in North Dakota where the durum business is booming, right? Because they have the right temperature.
Right amount of rainfall and the right
temperature. Right, exactly. Yeah. So they have the right temperature for that. But unfortunately, because of what we're doing to the planet, temperature has been rising significantly, okay? And so farmers are realizing they're having a more difficult time finding the right area to grow the durum wheat, which in turn makes the food prices go up. But to add insult to injury in North Dakota, all of a sudden, fracking has become very popular there. Okay, yeah. They found that that's a great area for natural gas, so more fracking is happening. And what they're doing is, as you guys already know, when it comes to fracking, they'll take fresh water, which, by the way, lots of parts of the country right now are facing drought. So to take a huge amount of fresh water, pump it into the ground so you can make the natural gas rise up. Mm. And then what do you do with that water? That tainted water goes into a huge pond, which then could leak into the fresh water supply. Yeah. And that's not good for our health, as you guys can imagine. But it's also causing damage to the environment. It's causing damage to durum wheat in North Dakota. And it just goes to show you that pretty soon we're going to have a discussion about pasta being extinct. And it sounds ridiculous, but wheat is what's used for pasta. So climate scientists are trying to raise more awareness about that. And I don't know if this will really strike a chord with people, but I hope it does, especially when you consider that, you know, this is a very, very important part of our food supply and it's being destroyed because of the way we're living and the amount of drilling we're doing.
Yeah, I think that the most depressing thing about the first, I'd say, 15 to 20 years of the battle to try to get the public to be interested in climate change and the effects of global warming is that for most people, they don't think about the effect of the weather outside of how it impacts what they wear day to day. Because, look, to be fair, people aren't botanists, they aren't biologists, they aren't meteorologists, they don't think about this stuff. And I think that Sandy and another extreme weather, if it has any sort of silver lining to the major, huge Franken clouds that they're developing, is that it puts at least in perspective in terms of environmental damage what global warming can do. Mm-hmm. And these most recent articles about bacon and coffee and now wheat are doing the same thing. Because people don't understand that if the temperature goes up 2 or 4 degrees Celsius, that doesn't mean that you just turn the dial on the AC a little bit. We're not air conditioning fields of wheat. Yeah, although we might have to.
Let me give you a specific example, and this is, again, from the Daily Beast and Newsweek. Already, a mere 1 degree Fahrenheit of global temperature rise over the past 50 years has caused a 5.5% decline in wheat production, according to David Lobel, a professor at Stanford University's Center on Food Security and Environment. Yeah. So that's a very specific example for you right there. Yeah. And so it's having these huge ramifications on our environment, on our food supply, and as I'm reading this story that's, you know, scientifically backed, I can't help but get so furious at the fact that we've heard numerous stories on the stupid so-called apocalypse and how the world's gonna come to an end at 2012, like people panicking about it, the doomsday preppers that are like, you know, building their underground bunkers and storing food and doing. There's no science behind that. And in the meantime, you have
Mayans,
these.
They were smart guys. No, it's stupid. We are actually facing some world-changing devastation, but we have at least maybe a couple of years, maybe a couple of decades to do something about it. It's not in December. No, but it is depressing. And so I remember I read actually fairly recently in 2007, I think it was, The Guardian talked about a report that a 4 degrees centigrade a change in temperature globally could cut rice production by 30%.
Yeah.
Yeah, that impacts parts of the world. I know in the middle of America they don't eat rice all that often, or maybe rice-a-roni or something like that. But that matters. Like, we're not exactly rolling in wheat as it is. Rolling in corn thanks to subsidies, so cows eat well. Mm-hmm. But in terms of the food that we actually eat, we don't have enough of it as it is. We can't afford to lose 5.5%, let alone 30%.
Yeah, and I can't emphasize enough, you know, you're already seeing the impact right now. You go to the grocery store and you see how expensive your groceries are. That isn't a coincidence, it isn't a mistake. It's happening as a result of climate change. And the fact that we still have people in this country that completely deny that it's happening, or accept that it's happening but deny that it's man-made, it just boggles my mind. Yeah. I don't know how much more evidence you could possibly need. And I think part of the reason why people don't want to accept it is because some people just don't want to change their lifestyle. Yeah. Yes, there's you know, the coal industry, there's big oil, and of course they have their interests to protect. But at the same time, there are people out there who would rather believe the pseudoscientists that are saying that it's not man-made because they don't want to change their lifestyles. It's easy.
Yeah.